This woman, Jehosheba, is our hero tonight because Jehosheba, listen, brothers and sisters, she shows us how God uses us to bless others even when it may not necessarily be our job. Jehosheba is the wife of the high priest, and it's the high priest's responsibility to protect the king and ultimately to protect the seed. We don't know what's going on with the high priest, where he is, what he's doing. All we know is that in his absence of action, whether through apathy or fear, his wife steps up and helps bless Joash, even though it's not necessarily her job. Oh, brothers and sisters, I pray that God would give his church the spirit of Jehosheba. That there are a lot of us, and I'm not trying to fuss at anybody, but there are a lot of us around and in churches that see all the needs, but very few people are willing to step up and do what it takes to meet the needs if it's not my job. We say things like somebody ought to or they should, but brothers and sisters, wherever you see a need, God is calling you to ministry. God is saying, I'm not exposing you to the need for you to go tell somebody else to get the job done. I am putting inside of you a burden and a burning and a yearning for things to get better. And here, my brothers and sisters, is the surest sign of spiritual maturity. Spiritual maturity is evidenced when you can do the work without needing the glory. Brothers and sisters, that's what Jehosheba teaches us. I don't need the position to perform the function, and I can be clear that God can use me without a title, without a business card, without a plaque, without a pat on the back. If I can help somebody as I pass along, if I can cheer someone with a word or with a song, if I can tell someone they're traveling wrong, then my living will not be in vain.